Jadi hidup ke mati ni?
Kalau dia bangun, perfect. Dia tak boleh perform CPR.
Tak, tak, tak. Lain sekali macam mana? Tepuk je dah. Tepuk macam mana?
Hello, hello. Cik, hello, hello, hello.
Oh, tepuk macam tu je. Ya.
Bau
je. Ya. Bau
macam selalu macam ni. Okay, right?
Aha.
Okay. Pada, okay, because you know why? Kadang-kadang, you nampak orang gebah di jalan. Tapi orang tu, tidur.
Ha?
Kalau bangla tidur tepi jalan, you nak buat CPR juga? Tak kan? Or, you nampak satu body jatuh gebah. Hmm. But you don't perform a CPR.
Hmm.
Kenapa? Kalau kepala putus, you don't perform the CPR kan? Yeah. So, kalau kata macam you jumpa satu badan, tiba-tiba, oh, ada you nak buat CPR? No. You tengok. Kalau tak ada kepala, takkan you nak buat CPR?
Oh, so, tengok ada kepala atau tidak?
Yes. Kalau decapitated, you don't perform the CPR lah kan? Okay.
Lepas tu? Itu je satu. Tapi kalau orang tu mungkin dalam koma, dia tak akan bangun pula.
Ada koma, dia koma.
Tapi tepuk-tepuk kita tak tahu.
You don't see a person koma. Dahlah kau dah koma, you tengok lah. The compression airway breathing jugalah.
Bukan, bukan, bukan. Tadi tu tepuk-tepuk tu,
dia
tak bangun. Sebab dia dalam koma. Tapi dia belum mati. Macam mana kita tak tahu dia mati?
So you have to do lah, tengok ada breathing, ada
nadi.
Pas. Usually dulu they ask you to feel here, right? Because you know why? Kata orang putus tangan. Kalau sini tak ada nadi, miss, you don't have a head already. If you don't have a head, you cannot taste the nadi kan? Alright?
Macam mana check nadi mana?
Macam tak buka, tak buka lah kan? Alright. Okay, just that you say that you all know how to check nadi ke. Okay, fine. Okay, fine. There's no breathing, there's no
nadi,
right? You start to perform the CPR. Okay? If you do not want, if you see frothy mouth or bleeding or a lot of orang kata apa, sometimes you got a lot of apa tu wound jatuh kan, jatuh tersembam, bengkak. You cannot perform that kan? So you start chest only CPR. That means you do the compression saja.
Cuma tuan doktor, yang berlaku di depan mata ketika ada satu kejohanan jatuh depan mata, mulut dia berbuih. Betul lah, dia tepuk-tepuk dulu, kemudian dibuat melalui hidung.
Itu usually for children. Kalau you nak buat boleh, you can melalui hidung. Tapi you have to close the mouth. Sebab bila you tak close the mouth, the air will come out through the mouth.
Sebab dia nak bersihkan, sebab dia dah bersihkan tu, barulah dia buat. Mula-mula dia buat.
Kalau dia nak buat, boleh. But if you do not want, pun boleh. Because you nak bersihkan dulu. It takes time.
Tapi boleh melalui hidung lah.
Boleh, boleh. Tapi you have to close the mouth. Kalau for children, kita buat mouth and nose. For infants. Jadi dia macam cup lah, macam suction cup. If you throw the nose, dia akan keluar through the mouth. So you must pinch, okay? Alright. That's why bila kita buat CPR kita, and you do mouth to mouth, you pinch the nose. Nanti that question, that area you will come. Yes, because it is in the circulation. So if you tak nak buat mouth to mouth, because you akan waste time, not, you know, you just start chest compression. Okay? So you just continue chest compression. Okay. The rate of chest compression, rate of chest
nak
compression.
Nak tekan mana?
Dekat dia kan. Okay. Is nanti I tunjuk macam mana ya. Alright, how to.
Tak, saya pun tak tahu macam mana ni.
Okay, say lah, this is her chest, ya? Okay, so you put your hands like this, and then put in between, right? Your, apa tu? How do you call it? Elbow, straight, ya? Yeah? Straight? Okay. You kalau you ikut dia punya nipple line, right? Okay, just at the nipple line, center to the at the sternum, you just press.
Sternum.
Optimus tahu apa tu? Ngoh. Minta maaf, Optimus tak tahu nipple line.
Tadi dulu tadi we started anatomy, right? All right. This is the chest, right?
Ah.
Lama pula lah macam tu juga.
Tak apalah, buatlah. Okay, tambah lah. Lepas ni kita, okay. Lepas ni kita pergi makan awal.
Okay, right.
Apa tu? Makan Thai.
This is the
stand-up
lah.
Oh, stand-up. Oh. Aha. Okay. Ingat pakai Thai.
Okay, this is the nipple line, right? So, add the nipple line, right? You put your... Yang tangan tadi. So, you...
Macam mana nak tahu? Kena tengok.
So, kena buat lah. That's why it's easier.
Just ask. My nipple line ni, kalau tak nampak, macam mana? Kena tengok.
So, kalau you kata orang tu tak ada nipple, or mastectomy, or, you know? Tak ada
bukan. Oh.
Alright, so you go pakai, you trace towards you punya ribs, yeah, ribs up, two finger breath.
Tanda tangan
tu jari, senang pakai tu jari. Apa? Two finger breath from your sini stand ni. So two finger breath, you letak ke tangan and you press.
Oh, ni sternum ni yang rib cage yang sambung tu.
Yang tengah.
Yang tengah tu, jadi dua.
Two finger breath from the sini stand.
Aha.
Macam ni tangan dia?
Macam ni? Dari belakang ke? Dari tepi ke? Sini, kita
right on top. And then you bukan rock eh. You don't rock eh. You just tekan. You don't do like this. Rocking. So you press hard.
Maksudnya kita diri tepi dia lah.
Kita diri on the side lah. You cannot do it like this. You have to do like this. This is the person. This is the knee. You do like this and you press hard and fast. You press hard and you press fast.
Hard and fast.
Hard and fast. I have a video who show how do you press hard and fast. Yeah. So the rate. Is
how hard? Kalau patah kan dia punya.
So it is actually for adult is 2 inches.
Huh?
2 inches.
So 2 inches.
Kalau less than 2 inches.
2 inches apa maksud dia?
Deep. And then you have to allow full recoil. Alright. So you have to, dia ada rate dia, yeah? Dia ada rate dia. So you have to fast in, you kena angkat. Dia ada recoil. Because behind your recoil, then the blood goes back to the heart. When you pump, the blood goes back to your brain. Because the important is your brain.
Kalau
tersalah buat, doesn't matter. Don't the person is already.
Buat je lah.
What worse can happen?
Mati 2 kali lah.
First thing is life. You must save life. So kata you buat tiba-tiba prak ke sini, dia mati.
Patah, terpatah.
Would you continue? Continue. That's the matter. Especially kalau you buat orang tua kan.
Haa, osteoporosis.
Tak apa, dia dah mati. You want a person with a tulang patah alive, or you want a person with tak ada tulang patah mati? No, there's no good Samaritan Act yet. Kalau ada good Samaritan Act, yes.
Jadi pam je tanpa perlu yang master.
So the rate is actually if siapa biasa dengar lagu Staying Alive.
Oh, lagu Bee Gees lama tu.
Yes, if you have you can pasang.
Tak ada pasang. Kena pergi YouTube lah cari.
Okay. So the rate is actually Staying Alive is about 100 per minute. So if you have in your, you can put in your phone. So you just do. The rate is 100 per minute. Ikut lagu, you can. That is 100 per minute. This used by, it is used by the American Heart Association for training purposes. It's used by the British Heart Association for training purposes. Staying alive is like a pun lah. Is that right? It is staying alive.
So masa
okay.
PTM tu kena ajar lagu tu lah.
So.
Lagu PTM.
Tak. But the conscience is with you. I tak touch lagi the legal aspect, the psychological aspect which usually we don't teach. Bila UPM minta, dia tak minta the psychological aspect, the legal aspect, because the psychology on the person yang membuat CPR tu. Once only I gave this lecture di science. Setakat
ni dekat negara mana?
Atau China. Oh. China.
Puan, lagu ni Puan.
Okay. Yes. Tak. 100 per minute. So you do 5 rounds of 30.
Ambil gambar. Buat je dah.